Earn, come on, man. I'm old, man. There's no reason. I'm going to push the Y, okay, Earn? Deal, Earn. What, Bishop? What? You know the deal. Earn. I don't want to say it out loud because they ain't supposed to know about it, Earn. Bishop just laughing with his dastardly laugh.
The Los Angeles Lakers and Charlotte.
Dick Dastardly. What's his name?
With Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr, I'm Kevin Harlan, bringing you the NBA live on 2K Sports. Along with Doris Burke, who will be joining us courtside moments from now. All right, let's set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. So for the Lakers right now, Lynn and Kobe are your one and your two. Hill is up there with Davis, and it's Johnson in at the three slot. Here's Kidd Gilchrist, and Lynn comes to help.
Hey, he's just a Kid Gilchrist.
Michael Kidd Gilchrist. Second overall pick back in 2012.
Come on, Art. Stop bowling.
As you know, an NCAA champion. You saw it firsthand with Kentucky.
Yeah, you know, I like his disposition, and I love his motor. I mean, his defense, his size, athleticism. He's an excellent rebounder for his position and size. He can defend up to three or four positions on the court. You know, you look at him, and I don't like to compare guys, Kevin, but, you know, he reminds me a bit of a young Gerald Wallace type.
From 10 feet out, rebounded by the Lakers.
Hey, Ert, you're stealing every outlet pass out y'all to throw, man.
And so it looks like the Lakers will retain possession here.
Throw me a ball here.
They're fortunate that one was just deflected and not stolen. Dodged a bullet there.
And for Kidd Gilchrist, the knock has always been about his outside shooting ability. You know, his shot has a big hitch in it. He shoots it on the way down. So there's a lot of fundamental issues with that stroke.
And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Well, you look at that shooting motion for MKG. Boy, that thing is broke at this point. It's going to be hard for him to fix it, but I think he can. I think it's still not beyond being modified. If that happens, the sky's the limit. He just turned 21, so he's got a chance to get that jumper right.
Well, Ed Davis, in his fifth season out of North Carolina, he's had to battle for minutes both in Toronto and Memphis, but has produced when he's been on the court. An active, athletic big man. He's a player to watch.
Now Kobe, following the miss by Al Jefferson from deep. Kobe with it, picked up by Kidd Gilchrist. That's tipped. And it's the Hornets ball. And Davis with good mobility for his size. Offensively, Clark, he can run in transition, flash to the basket. Mm-hmm. At the other end, he's a good help defender.
Yeah, and bit by bit, Kevin, we see him developing his post game as well. He's starting to broaden out that skill set. Still only 25 years old. Come on now. He's got a lot left in his development.
Wes Johnson, the former number four pick back in 2010. He was a bust in Minnesota, but he shot better in his fourth season. And once he was moved to kind of a small four, like the shooting power forward spot, he really found a niche for himself.
Williams, he's checked in for Charlotte. And Wesley Johnson has always been impressive physically. Great size, terrific length for a wing, quick off the floor.
Yeah, he's got all of those ingredients, but his ball handling has been a bit mediocre, rather pedestrian, and I think that's held him back offensively.
It's Davis with the drive. And they get it back.
Dang, all right.
And the foul on Al Jefferson. Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. And there's Davis. That's good on the assist from Kobe.
See the way he times his passes so well? That was a great assist.
Stevenson outside. Johnson with the block. And pushing it up, here's Los Angeles. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
Yeah, he put himself in great position to finish that break off, guys.
Yep, right to the rack.
Jefferson kicks to Stevenson. Williams, a screen on Hill. Stevenson inside the three-point line. Now in transition is Lynn. Here we go. Johnson, a wide-open look. No good off the back of the rim. Stevenson with it, and it's Lynn picking him up. Pass to Johnson. And Marvin Williams picks up the foul.
All right, what you doing, this dude?
Davis with the jam.
You know, he may not have the elevation or the hop. He doesn't need it, though. The big fella throwing it down anyway.
He usually does save the high flying for the little guys. Clark, you're right.
Yeah, well, sometimes it looks like he's pinned to the ground, but when he gets positioned like that, I mean, he can put it down.
Lakers leading by three. Big part of why the Hornets were able to improve so much last year is they had an identity. And Steve, a veteran presence on the team. And that goes a long way.
Well, they've had talent for quite some time, but without direction, it's not easy to make anything of it. I just think getting Al Jefferson in the middle kind of tied all those pieces together.
Well, he won that battle, and in general, they're winning most of the battles tonight.
Well, those are some very easy points if you can get them.
Well, and like Clark said, they have been getting them, not necessarily all on putback dunks, but a lot of second chance opportunities.
So Charlotte calls timeout. They're first.
And for the Hornets, you know, hey, they had some low points in the season, but they still found a way to rally around each other and not let things spiral south like they had in the past. Kudos to them for showing that kind of result.
Nick Young's checked in for Jeremy Lin. Walker dishes to Jefferson. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Jordan Hill. Cody Zeller's checked in for Marvin Williams.
Cody Zeller.
Kid Gilchrist again. He's Young. Kid Gilchrist, no luck.
Well, one of the dynamics for this Bobcats team last year was they had a lot of veteran presence, so they're able to deal with adversity, get through that in advance, and I thought that really helped band this team together last year, and they went on to make the postseason.
Everything going according to the script for them offensively so far.
Yeah, the shots have been falling, that's for sure. The offense really in a good groove.
And here's Los Angeles. They've outscored him 10 points to 2 during this run. The try by Bryant. Hill, no good.
You know, they've been beating this club to a lot of loose balls and rebounds here early on.
Love the work ethic they've come out of the locker room with.
And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, the shot misses. He'll be shooting two. And the Lakers get called for the foul. The Hornets shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
Well, and they were 74% free throw shooting as a team last year, so those numbers could come up.
And I know the free throw shooting is an area they focused on improving coming into this season.
Bryant is doubled. And here's Johnson outside. It's rebounded by Charlotte.
Michael Kidd-Gilchrist missing 6 weeks last season with a broken hand. And frankly, he took a step back overall. His numbers getting worse almost across the board.
He's one of the guys they don't mind taking the three in transition when he's that open. He's lethal out there.
Kobe against Walker. Johnson over to help. Six on the shot clock. A three from Stevenson. But they'll get another chance.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period. Boy, but he was close, Kevin, to making the defense pay for lackadaisical coverage there.
Yeah, he had a really good look. I mean, he'll knock that down more often than not.
Oh, my goodness.
And then Johnson with the dunk.
I don't need no alley-oop dunk.
Their offense has really come together immediately, threatening to run away with this game.
It's hard to imagine they'll be able to stay as hot as they've been so far, but if they can, watch out.
Charlotte calls timeout.
Well, Kobe Bryant last season for the first time introducing high tops as his custom basketball shoes, looking to provide a little more support for that injured Achilles.
So a whole new group on the floor now for Charlotte. And then for the Lakers. Randall's checked in for Hill. Boozer comes in for Davis. And it's Henry in for Johnson. Here's Neal. And once again, off the mark by Charlotte. And Kobe had been wearing ultra-low tops. Do you think that contributed, Clark, at all to his Achilles injury?
No, I won't point to that. An Achilles injury is a freak injury. I mean, it can happen any number of ways. It's just a freak thing, in my opinion.
Well, Julius Randle, drafted out of Kentucky after one season. He fits that classic power forward mold. 6'9", strong, physical, great rebounder, and scores with his back to the basket.
Shot by Roberts, no good.
Boy, that's a surprising miss right there. He usually feasts on those wide-open opportunities.
And that one's good, Henry.
They've built a big lead here early.
Both defensively and offensively. They've been terrific right from the tip.
And Randle, regarded as a good outside shooter at high school.
I don't know why he even did that. Kobe could have gotten him.
And I think he wants to show that he can be a floor spacer at the NBA level, but it may take some time. That would really help him offensively because he is a tad undersized at the power forward spot. So being able to shoot it from the perimeter would go a long way in his development.
Here is Bryant, following the bucket by the Hornets. The Lakers need to get a shot off here. Henry misses.
That's a shot you've got to take if you're looking for the three-pointer. I mean, the defense was nowhere around.
Out of bounds, the Lakers will take possession.
Well, I think that pass caught him off guard, but he showed us board hands, too.
Lakers leading by 12. And Bryant kicks to Henry. Back to Bryant. 6 to shoot. In the corner, Henry with it.
Boy, I shot terrible.
And as the first quarter wraps up, already a double-digit lead. The Lakers on top. They lead by 12.
Gotta shoot better, guys.
And we welcome you back to start the quarter. Players had a chance to get hydrated with Gatorade. And there's certain to be some great basketball ahead for us. And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for Los Angeles.
Boy, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively. I mean, really contesting and even blocking shots. Definitely a factor early.
And they're getting out in transition, too, finding some easy points on the fast break.
So on the floor for the Lakers to start this second quarter. Hoosier is out there with Xavier Henry. Then there's Nick Young. Then it's Randall. And it's Clarkson in at the point.
Lakers last season, and this is a remarkable factoid here, folks, that was only the sixth time in franchise history, going all the way back to the 40s, that the Lakers had missed the playoffs. Obviously, the Lakers fans are not accustomed to missing the postseason.
Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, what do you have?
Well, Kevin, Al Jefferson, a veteran leader, and he's changed the Hornets locker room. A former coach, Doc Rivers, said, you know the people in your life who just bring sunshine? That's Al. He brings it wherever he goes. And guys, Big Al said of his young teammates, I don't talk much, but they really wanted to listen.
Dora is just an easygoing guy. Great presence. Thank you.
And the generous spirit, too, Kevin, is Al Jefferson. I mean, in Utah, he never hesitated to mentor their young guys.
And for the Lakers last season, Steve, with the departure of Dwight Howard, you knew the team on paper had less talent, but the hope was that the chemistry would improve.
And I thought it did. The chemistry was good. Kevin, they just didn't have enough talent. And when Kobe and Nash went down, it didn't matter who was out there, who was coaching. You know, it was just going to be a situation where they were not going to be able to win enough games.
Crazy, huh?
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. That's his first foul. Second quarter of action, about a minute and a half played. Here's Clarkson. From down in the low post, it goes. Clarkson's got his first 2 points. Charlotte calls timeout. It's not very often you can say this about the future is looking pretty bright in Charlotte.
So often the season ends and you're thinking about the issues you've got to deal with, but right now the Hornets headed in a good direction.
Hornets trail by 10.
Where's Wesley Johnson doing up there?
And for Charlotte, as you said, you know, part of it is feeling good with their direction, but also they should feel good that they actually have a direction after the way the last few years have gone.
There's the double team with Walker. Puts it up. Here's Randall. And there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time. And the Lakers lead by 9. And Jefferson wide open. He shoots. That one wide left.
You know, having a direction, as you mentioned, had been a problem with Charlotte because they seemed to change their minds every year about who they were going to be. And they did it for the last decade or so. Now it seems as though the base is solid and they've got an idea of how they want to build and who they want to build around. And they've got a group that can grow together.
For Charlotte, they've gone 3-7 shooting the ball here in the second quarter. They're running. Young with no one around. They get it back. Tries again.
Now can't
shoot. Charlotte takes possession. And the Hornets making a change here. Williams has checked in. They set the pick. And Walker kicks to Williams. Inside. He's looking for Kidd-Gilchrist and finds him. Los Angeles leading by 9. Uses both hands to slam it down. An indication there of why the scoreboard looks like it does. Very passive defense.
But the finish was anything but passive.
No, he hammered that down, Clark. Superb above the rim action.
Kevin, I didn't like that defensive effort at all, but they're lucky he missed it.
Yeah, they were very lucky defensively because there was some miscommunication there. They left him wide open.
Walker goes in. That ball. Nice feed that time from Stevenson. And that's now 8 points for Kemba Walker. Lance Stevenson, Steve, an attack guard, always looking to pressure the defense with the ball in his hands.
And not just looking for his own shot, Kevin. Last season, he averaged over 4 assists a game. So, you know, he provides some much-needed playmaking, which I think helps his team.
Ryan Roberts is checked in for the Hornets. Some changes for the Lakers. They double him with Stevenson. Pass to Hill. Johnson, wide open, he fires. Bangs home the trifecta. Johnson's got 14 points.
And for Stevenson off the ball, all the work he's put into improving that perimeter shot has paid dividends. He's steady from out there now, and he is a floor spacer. He was deadly last season from the right corner shooting that tray ball.
Gerald Henderson, he's checked in for Charlotte. Gary Neal comes in for Lance Stevenson. Johnson, the pass to Lynn. For three, that's good from Johnson on the assist by Lynn. And that's 17 points for Johnson.
And Stevenson always looking to push the tempo in transition, a great finisher, and his decision-making in those situations has come a long way.
Man, you're Wesley, you're paying attention.
Out of bounds, Charlotte takes possession. Quick hands and the ability to anticipate the opening to create a turnover, so valuable, especially for a guard, as we see two tremendous talents with their ability to steal that ball away.
Then, of course, you look at the numbers. John Stockton with 3,265 steals over his career. Really a crazy number. Averaged over 2 a game. And even in his later years, he was a threat in that regard.
And the call goes against Wesley Johnson. That's his first foul. Here's Neal. There's a screen by Williams. And Lynn comes to help. The kick out to Williams. Shot clock at 6. From deep, Neal. And another 3 for Charlotte.
After having none in the first, he gets 2 3-point shots to go here.
Well, the Lakers were coming into the season with only about $11 million in salary committed, a chance to attract 2 max free agents, but when they gave Kobe Bryant that 2-year, $50 million extension, well, that seems to possibly postpone the rebuild that the Lakers have by maybe 2 more years.
Here's Hill. Yes! And a nice assist from Lynn.
Well, he knew that with his height advantage over his man, it was really a good decision just to rise up and take the jump shot. Intelligent passing there to make that hoop possible.
And a great player like Kobe Bryant, who spent Clark his entire career with one team, he deserves to retire a Laker. He feels that way, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, absolutely, Kevin. I feel exactly the same way. You love to see guys who've had the impact on a team and on the league the way Kobe has, as a box office draw and winning. You'd like to see those guys be one-team guys, and I'd be surprised if Kobe's not in that category. In 2016, though, Russell Westbrook and Kevin Durant hit free agency. Uh-oh, might be some forward thinking going on here as well, partner.
Back to Bryant. Bryant is doubled. Here's Johnson. Zeller with the double team. And here is Los Angeles now. Hill kicks to Johnson. Bryant has the open look. The shot misses. Now Charlotte takes it the other way.
Well, it seems like they're getting a little fat and sassy here, complacent in the second quarter.
Fat and sassy. on, Clark. I mean, we're seeing their free throw attempts diminish, but how about calling them fat and sassy? That seems kind of harsh.
Lakers leading by 12. On the wing, Johnson. They get it again. Tries again. And that one's good by Kobe.
Well, it's kind of been the story here today, hasn't it, Clark?
Here's Roberts. No good with the layup.
I thought he rushed it a little bit, guys, because he had a clean look. Just lost his focus.
And we finish one half of basketball. Lakers lead by 14. 2K Sports, back in a moment here at the...
See you somewhere. I can't shoot today, man.
Well, it's been a one-sided affair so far through the first two quarters, but there's plenty of time to mount a comeback.
Wesley Johnson has been great. He has 17 points, and the three-pointers have been dropping for him. He's got three of them.
Well, as long as he's continuing to make them, I think they should make him more of a focal point of this offense.
At the three, MKG and Cody Zeller at the four. Walker runs the point with Stevenson flanking him. And it's Jefferson in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And that's the group for Steve Clifford as we begin the second half. The feed now to Kobe. Down to five on the shot clock. On the wing, Johnson. Kemba Walker comes up with the loose ball.
Last season, Kemba Walker's per game numbers were pretty comparable to his breakthrough second season, but his efficiency shooting the ball dropped a little bit overall. He was under 40% from the field last season.
Here's Stevenson. And he banks in the layup.
Boy, you love to get those easy lay-ins to get your offense going. They're clicking here to start the second half.
Kicks to Lynn. Davis drives in. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
Well, now's the time to do it. Keep attacking that rim.
Stevenson inside the three-point line. Again, the Hornets score.
Guys, they've had a solid start to the second half offensively. Gotten good looks, and they've made three out of four of them.
Lynn against Walker. Lynn's shot is off. Hornets trail by 12. Stevenson with it. And it's Johnson picking him up. Charity stripe shot. Misses off the right iron.
He has not been on his game, and you know they're totally on him, but he has not helped the situation.
Outside, Kobe. Outside, Lynn. Kicks it out to Johnson. From past the arc. The shot no good. And Charlotte will go the other way with it. A touch over 2.5 minutes of basketball played here in the third quarter. Stevenson. Rebound the Lakers. Davis has got 5 rebounds tonight. And Johnson with the stop.
Now that is a quick bucket. Pretty good in transition.
That's right. That's exactly right. He loves when he gets the chance to get out and run. That's when he's at his best.
Charlotte calls timeout. Conley's checked in for Charlotte. Henderson comes in for Kidd Gilchrist. The Lakers also changing it up. Randall comes in for Davis. And Nick Young is subbed in for Jeremy Lin. Kicks it out to Stevenson. And taken away by Johnson. Young with no one around. A rebound by Jefferson.
Most of the time, that shot will go down. Or the defenders have to make sure they tag.
Stevenson dishes to Jefferson. Shot is off. Excellent D there from Hill. Lakers leading by 14. And Wesley Johnson with the slam.
Boy, the prettiest play in basketball to me. Executed to perfection.
I don't think you're going to get an argument there. Everybody loves the alley-oop.
Well, unless you're the team getting dunked on, of course.
Don't be bumping my dude,
the Hornets are certainly showing signs of development and improvement, and that's not all they're doing to put fans in the seats. Those who bought season tickets last season got season tickets for this season for free. That meant tickets as cheap as $3.25 a game. Wow, that's a heck of a deal.
You know, that putback's about as easy as it's going to get. You have to put a body on someone down there.
Well, no box out. That's the result you get right there.
Henderson against Young. He dishes it to Kobe. The kick out to Young. Clock at 4.
Even though he isn't having the best of games from the floor, it hasn't seemed to hurt him.
It's tipped. And now it's Hill running. He can go all the way. And the rebound goes to the Hornets. And this franchise, known for its first 9 years as the Bobcats, has now claimed the Hornets' name and looks to start anew.
Well, to this point, you know, the worst winning percentage among active NBA franchises and not a single playoff win. It's easy to see why they would embrace a different tradition with the Hornets' name.
Back to Kobe. Young outside. There's the triple. Second chance shot. And there's the nice layup by Hill. Hill's got 6.
It's been a great day for them on the boards, Clark. That's definitely been a major factor in building this big lead.
And, you know, from a number standpoint, the advantage might not be.
Man, he jumped over him.
Hurried down that time.
Now, Clark, that is just ridiculous.
Absolutely filthy.
Oh,
I don't remember ever seeing a dunk like that in a game. I certainly can't remember the last time I saw one.
Oh, man, that was just amazing.
Lakers leading by 18. Ryan in the post. Henderson defending. Young passes to Johnson. Lets it go with a 3. And Nick Young, the bucket on the assist by Johnson. He's got 8.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
Yeah, they're making the right play, they're working together, and they're just looking for the best shot they can every possession.
Young with the ball. Now guarded by Stevenson. And Kobe gets it to go.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the lead.
You know, there's always a lot of nicknames in the NBA. I loved what became of Nick Young last year in L.A. All of a sudden, he dubbed himself Swaggy P, and it caught on. It seemed like the whole league kind of loved watching him play and referring to him by that nickname.
You know, he's been off his game this quarter just a bit. Hasn't been able to get a whole lot to go so far.
And here's Los Angeles. They're on a 17-6 run.
Wesley Johnson.
And the slam dunk by Johnson.
Well, they're winning the speed game, guys, getting out in transition.
Boy, I like the energy they play with offensively and in the open court. Tremendous flow.
Henderson kicks to Walker. Henderson! Nails it from the high post. Walker's got 10 points. Here's Young. He's got 8. Up top, Henderson, defended by Bryant. And Kobe Bryant gets the whistle that time. That's foul number 2 for him. Some changes for Charlotte. Yambo, he's checked in for Jefferson. Gary Neal comes in for Lance Stevenson. And Brian Roberts subbed in for Walker. The Lakers also changing it up. Boozer, he's checked in for Hill. Henry comes in for Wesley Johnson. And it's Clarkson in for Bryant. Wayne Ellington's checked in for Los Angeles. Henry passes to Clarkson. Nice ball movement here by the Lakers. And Ellington is good for three.
You know, it's really hard not to notice the difference in the passing of these two teams today.
Yeah, look at the discrepancy in this, the assist column between these two teams. Boy, they've really dominated on the glass, and of course they've done a lot of good things here tonight, but the rebounds have played a major factor.
Hey, Steve, you know rebounding always one of the key barometers in determining the victor.
And it's out of bounds. The Lakers able to retain possession here. From the arc. Can't get it to go. And at the end of the third quarter, a huge lead, and this one may already have been.
Come on, y'all. Come on. Got a long way to go.
And Los Angeles guys shooting 52% from the floor. Nice work so far from them. And on the court for the Lakers to start the fourth. Randall out there with Boozer. Then it's Xavier Henry. Then there's Wayne Ellington. And it's Clarkson in at the one spot. Here's Walker. And that one's good.
Well, I tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
Here's Clarkson. And Jefferson with the block. Deflects the pass. And Kid Gilchrist kicks to Zeller. Pass to Stevenson. Kept alive. Jefferson. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
We've watched Jefferson play great basketball. He's got 10 rebounds, and he's added a steal to his stat line also.
Now, that's obviously not a big number, but you know, he's been doing some valuable defensive work for them. Al Jefferson last season posting about 22 points and 11 boards. Still not selected as an all-star, and when you think about it, Big Al undoubtedly one of the most productive players never to receive an all-star nod.
And for the Hornets, they're shooting a meager 37% for the game. Oh, and there's the one-handed jam. And that's how you exploit a gap in the D, I guess, huh?
Yes, sir. No soft finish there. Major power.
Wow. He knows an opportunity for the highlight reel when he sees one.
Here's Henry. That one off the back iron and out. And Jefferson, a terrific locker room presence, leading the Bobcats back to the playoffs, Clark, for the second time in franchise history.
Yeah, they run their whole offense through him, and with good reason, Kevin. He's not just their scoring leader. He's also, as you indicated, their leader, period.
He's easygoing. He's friendly.
Yep, and he gets other guys to toe the line.
Boozer, no good.
Boy, they were ready for him right there. I mean, totally collapsed the defense on it.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. That's his fourth foul of the contest. And that one good from Clarkson.
All right, your guys
Clarkson's
got Jokic.
Got six here in this quarter.
Keep doing the, what you call it over here, man?
Three from Stevenson.
Bless man. Keep doing that bless man
and
on
Jefferson
me.
Throws it down hard.
Look at that effort and energy as he creates the second chance and then converts.
He doesn't just convert, Clark. He converts with maximum force.
He could give lessons on the art of offensive rebounding.
Ellington dishes to Randall. They double him with Stevenson. Shot clock at six. Henry with it. Now guarded by Stevenson. Here's Ellington. The shot is off. Some solid defense from Kidd-Gilchrist. Stevenson inside the three-point line. Another shot. And it's Stevenson again missing.
You can see the struggles that he's had from the field are really starting to get to him.
Got a piece of it. Stolen by Walker. Here's Kid Gilchrist.
Boy, just an excellent assist. Nice work from Kemba Walker.
A look at the clock, a little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. Clarkson passes to Henry.
Well, you know, this last draft class was one that had been hyped up for such a long time with the big names, primarily Wiggins, Parker, and Embiid, all being viewed as potential franchise players. I'm not quite sure of that, but they certainly are tremendous talents. A lot of teams knew that, and it became a bit of the race to the bottom for some franchises.
Timeout called, the Lakers.
Well, Cody Zeller out of Indiana, the younger brother of Tyler Zeller, who was drafted in 2012. And Cody at 6'11", played center for the Hoosiers. More of a power forward, though, at the NBA level.
And as most of you know, Cody Zeller from a family of seven-footers with older, bigger brothers. He had to develop his guard skills and learn to score away from the basket.
You know, Kevin, he actually played point guard on his high school JV team, you know, going back a few years. So he has the skills to play the four. He's an underrated athlete, too, and I thought that would be the case, having watched him at Indiana. I like what I've seen from him thus far.
Looking at who's out there now for the Hornets, Williams comes in for Zeller. And Gary Neal subbed in for Lance Stevenson. So it's the Lakers now. Inside to Jefferson. 11 feet away.
You know, so many games are decided by which team wins the rebound battle. And that's held true in this one so far, Steve.
And even if it's only a modest advantage that they have in that category, it's still a significant factor.
Walker with it. And it's Johnson picking him up. Walker's shot is off.
Tell you what, the defense has nothing to worry about out there with him shooting. I mean, he can't dial it in from deep this half at
all. Good pass, Cole.
And that one's good.
Guys, that time he went for the fancy finish for us there, man. That was sweet.
And it's out of bounds to the Hornets as Charlotte retains possession.
Dang, Aaron.
Here's Neal. Outside, Walker. Williams with a clean look. The shot's good on the assist by Walker. Walker's got 5 assists in the game.
That is not enough coverage. Got to do better than that defensively. Basically, no coverage. I mean, defense did not look very good there.
Outside, Hill. It's Davis with the drive. Just 5 on the clock. Bryant gets a wide open look. That one's good from the corner.
Well, I doubt that was the plan there on that trip, guys, they did get the shot to go.
Out of bounds, the Lakers will take possession. Lakers leading by 21. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot 2. Walker picks one up.
Last season, a tough one for Kobe Bryant. He missed all but a handful of games. Early on, it was the Achilles tear he was rehabbing from, and then after 6 games, a fractured tibia took him out for the season.
And Kobe's shown that he can withstand age with a terrific individual season for him. You remember, Steve, back in 2012, 2013, and then, of course, the injury-plagued season last year.
Yeah, so now the challenge, of course, is can he overcome age and injury, and that's the challenge this year. Only time will tell, but one thing we do know, that nobody will work harder than Kobe Bryant.
An 8-rebound advantage like the one they have now is always going to swing the score hard in that team's direction.
And that's certainly been the case today. Their rebounding has made a huge difference.
And Kidd Gilchrist gets it to go in. Lakers leading by 23. Outside Bryant. Young in the corner. Here's Hill. And a good offensive board. And he gets the bucket.
They are not rotating nearly quickly enough on defense down low. Got to get quicker there.
And even if it costs them some foul trouble, I mean, they need to start putting some bodies on bodies. Be physical.
Well, that's not really his game. I mean, he shouldn't be shooting the ball from out there.
Kobe with it. He's picked up by Walker. Williams with the block.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, dominating performance for the Lakers.
And they could do no wrong today, Steve. That's right. This was a team performing to its Clark fullest capabilities.
Yeah, and a very satisfying win for them, too. A game to remember, and on the other side, definitely one you want to forget as soon as possible.
Fantastic show put on. What an amazing game all around it was for Wesley Johnson. He was doing everything right, and the points seemed to come in bunches. He definitely had the hot hand.
Really hard to find fault with anything he's doing this quarter, at least at the offensive end.
And it's Kidd Gilchrist penetrating. There's the block. And they get it back. Bryan against Walker. There's the dish to Young. Kidd Gilchrist with the steal.
Well, it looks like their comeback hopes are out the window. I think this lead is safe now.
Yep, this one's a done deal.
Neal's shot is off. And Los Angeles guys shooting at 42% in this final quarter. Johnson kicks to Bryant. Feeds to Young. So it's Los Angeles winning this one easily. They put on a show tonight, thoroughly controlling each end of the floor.
Hey, what more can you ask?
Thank you for joining us for this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports. For Clark, Stephen Doris, and the rest of the crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time. Last but not least, here is your Jordan Player of the Game, Wesley Johnson. All right.